If I love somebody and that person refuses to love me, I hurt because I have lost something. Right? Because I've lost something. Here, the issue of language becomes very critical. Language is used in three ways, said Aquinas: univocal, equivocal, and illogical. Univocal is when you use a word in two different sentences and it means the same thing. All right? So I say, I love you, and I love somebody else out there. You're not pausing to evaluate the word. You assume it's the same thing. It's a univocal usage. If I take it, the word equivocally, and I use the same word in different sentences, it means something different. If I say I'm a good tennis player, and then Roger Federer says he's a good tennis player, we still don't belong on the same court, because I want to see the ball that's coming. His context for good is completely different to my context for good, because in my context, I first got to see the ball. In his way, if he hit it my way, I doubt I'll even see it. But I use the same word. Sometimes we use words univocally, sometimes we use it equivocally, because it varies in the context. There's a third word, analogical. When I say I love you, and you refuse to love me, I hurt, because I've lost something. When God says he loves you, and you refuse to love God, God hurts too. God hurts not because he has lost something, but because you have lost something. The whole use of language in love and value, favor, comes to you in an analogy oftentimes. And you know, I become a grandfather once last year, and about to become a grandfather two more times. And today my daughter and son-in-law returned from Florence, Italy. They've just landed. I hadn't seen them for a month. I'm just longing to get back home so I can take that little guy and give him a big hug and squeeze all over again. My daughter said to me, what's the difference between parents and grandparents? Do you have any difference in feeling? I said, sweetheart, I'll tell you what, when you're a parent, all of your energy is expended in just taking care and worrying and providing for, you've got very little left to really enjoy it. Now when you're a grandparent, you do the worrying and you do the energizing, I'll take the enjoyment and I'll enjoy the little one. When you look at a young life and hold a little one in your arms, you have to ask yourself the question, what do you want for this child? Do you want it out of vanity? Or do you want it out of love and the supreme idea of what is life's purpose? Sometimes through suffering, sometimes through pain, sometimes through sacrifice. My prayer for that little boy is that he will always grow up to fulfill the law and the purpose that God has for him, and do it with honor and dignity. What path that will take, I don't know. God loves you for your sake and what's best for you. Because nothing you do this way or that way will make him less than God. But what you do can make you less than what it means to be human. I'll leave that.